Hello YouTube, and first of all I want to say I am sorry for not posting any videos lately. Now you know the situation about this coronavirus, and that has caused many things, like my school ended, and now I have to do those homeworks, so all things take longer in home than in the school, and we are banned from the school, so that's one thing. And one thing is all the living and so on is more difficult. So all the stores and so on, they work like normally, but schools and so on are closed. I don't go more to the details, but you know what I mean. Now I want to keep life going on, and that's why I want to make this video. So there has been so many things that I really don't want to even say all those. But anyway, I want to keep going, and please take care of yourself and your relatives, your friends, and so on. So, what we have here is Volta F1, and it has obviously that CPO-ET1 power head there, and also that back saver. Now, that back saver will affect that performance a bit. It will lower the airflow about 50 to 20 cfm, so it's not the best thing to use, but still this has 81 cfm if I remember correctly. Actually it was 83, but if I said it wrong, then I will correct that, but that is the nozzle CFM. So very early 90s vacuum, and it has a bit bad bearings, that motor in it, but very powerful vacuum, so it can deal with that back saver. So let's just show quickly what this Volta is about and what it is going to be. It is going to clean this very dirty rug, so I have not vacuumed this for some time, and like many of you know, I do those DIY things, and I do them on my table, what is normally sitting there. So yes, but now to the Volta, so let's look a bit closer. Okay, I hope you can see that, and this is going to be very quick, just to show you what we are dealing with. So there is that cable for the power here, wrapped around the hose, and bag compartment looks like that. So this actually has very well sealed bag and bag fitting. Not all canisters, especially old canisters or vacuums, have that very good sealed compartment. Now I don't even have to use that pre-motor filter because this has so good seal. I did that big mistake when I sucked it up a bag almost full of debris, and this was spotless. So I am not worried about that this vacuum doesn't have pre-motor filter. There is this dual tray. It goes there like that. There is that post-motor filter, and yes, it has some carbon dust there. This is not dust from the vacuuming floors and so on. This is carbon dust, what is normal for the motor to produce. Another word to say for Finnish people, what is hard to say. So, yes, this has seen some modifications, not something what I wanted to do, but what I had to do. So these screws keeps these pedals in place and in working order. So I like this shape a lot. So I mean, it is a very stylish vacuum. And there is that blower board what you can use if you want to blow air from the hose, or more better way to say is that if you want to use hose for those blowing jobs. And there is front, and this actually is have been sold in the USA, and that was Eureka Excalibur canister and with big powerhead. This original didn't come with powerhead in Europe. So Eureka Excalibur was the model sold in the USA. And now let's see that back saver. So you know this, you have seen this if you follow my channel. This has very good cyclone system. And this is empty, like you can see. And there is that cyclone. I have that another smaller back saver, but that is absolutely terrible. It basically steals all the air flow from the vacuum. It is much worse. This is pretty good actually. So let's put this hose back to the vacuum. And another way, I don't see what I'm doing from this angle. And it's there. And this combination is ready to fight with my very dirty Rook, and you will see that dirt going into the back saver. So let's go into that. Okay, so I hope that you can see this back saver when it is processing the dirt. Cyclone is processing the dirt in this back saver, and dirt is going to spin in there. So obviously this is now in the upright mode, but I will use this like this way, so I hope you can see that.
Okay, when I started vacuuming this lid, that full bearing noise. But when you turn this vacuum on, it will make that if you have not used that this vacuum for a long time. So yes, I did make that sound bearing noise, and those bearings are not serviceable, and you even can't take apart the motor, so that's too bad. But we have stuff in the back saver, and let's take this back saver off and see how much it is. Okay, back saver comes off. But first I shake this so there is nothing in the cyclone, because otherwise it is going to make a mess. So there is some stuff, and obviously that was very dirty rook, so you can see that. Now I move the camera angle, and let's see how much that actually is. Okay, moment of truth. How much there is? And yes, I like this just for one reason, and that is because I can show you the dirt what it picked up. Otherwise I don't use this. It makes a lot of that turbulence noise, I mean a lot, and then it will affect to the performance of the vacuum, so it will lower the performance of any vacuum when this is in use. But anyway, now so that's good amount of stuff, and I zoom in and I hope I can use this. This tripod is a bit broken, so there is, well, there actually is a lot of fine dust. This is not carpet fibers. This carpet, or rook in this case, doesn't really release so much. So I mean yes, it was dirty, and many of you might be wondering how on earth your rook is so dirty, or always seems to be so dirty. Well, I guess it is because I don't vacuum that often. So, and this was very thorough vacuuming. When I vacuum, I usually vacuum very quickly. And I have been using my Shark Rocket stick vacuum. So there is all kind of plastic parts, these blue ones. So that's very, very nice result. So let's go to the conclusion and see, is that Volta still making that noise? Oh. Okay, you are very close to the Volta, and now or never you will hear that bearing noise. So let's try this. One more time. Yes, it is better, but you can hear it. It's not healthy. So it this is so same, because it is so powerful, this vacuum, and I can get new motor for this two stages, about 1000 watt motor. This is 1200 watts, this motor. But 1000 watt motor is original Electrolux motor, and this uses Electrolux motors. So, yes.
So there is that dirt what you picked up. And all the comments are welcome, obviously. And we have to look that. Look. It looks good. But that is not surprise, because we use that SIBO ET1 powerhead, and yes, it is very nice powerhead. Actually, I can show quickly that what I mean. You are already very powered, but I have not made any videos. It has been almost 2 weeks. So if this lightning is showing this. So there is the Bruce roll. This has all the good features what you need in the powerhead. A lifetime belt, very strong motor, 175 watts, very good Bruce roll, not too stiff. I mean, all the bearings and so on, they are very high quality. Clean out port there. And best of all, this what should be in every powerhead. So if I can show that easily, yes. So that Bruce roll comes out, and of course it dropped some stuff. So yes. Now there is some weird channel things going on there, and there is something stuck in there. So there is one groove there to direct the dirt to the airbag. So Bruce roll is a bit stained, but this is the normal Bruce roll, and you can get that stiff, not stiff, that green, what is not this stiff. You can get that if you have wool, carpets or rugs or something very delicate. I didn't say that word right, but anyway. Now you can see that this is not easy, especially when you are filming. I don't know how I can get this now there, but come on, go there. This is normally so easy when you are doing it, but yes. And this stick out a lot, these bruises, like you can. I hope you can see that. So that's that, and this video was super long, but I really, really felt that I want to do this, because I have not made videos for a long time, so my ideas are also a bit thin right now for vacuum videos, but like you know, I do some crazy things time to time, so let's see what is next. And now, thanks for watching and goodbye.